had to do shift work to make the forecasts for the different venues and the public during the Olympics. And so Gordon had a worksheet, and it defined our schedule. And so we needed to have a person there. I think we had to get up at like 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning, go to the office, and do the morning forecasts for the public and the venues. And then another person might come in, say 8 or 9, and he had to hold the office, you know, because people would come in and ask questions and such. And then we might, or one of us might have to go out to a venue to take the observations for the events. So it was a pretty intense schedule of, I don't think we didn't have any time off. All four of us were doing something. And I think by the 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon, we might have had one more, not a conference call, but we'd go to some of the I remember particularly the cross country and jumping people and give them an update on the forecast, because they seemed to be more interested in the latest forecast for tomorrow's event. That was a drought year, 1980, in the Northeast. So from the summer into the fall, there wasn't much precipitation, and then winter comes, and it doesn't snow. It snowed very little. So the challenge is to make snow for the cross country and the downhill venues. And I recall vividly we had a cold snap probably middle of January, late January, maybe even to early Feb, where it was cold enough, and the Olympic organizers just pounced upon that opportunity to make just as much snow as they could. And I think they brought in all these extra snowmaking machines into Mount Van Hovenberg, and they made these amazing piles of snow that they then used to track out onto the cross-country course. And of course, at Lake Placid, they had snowmaking equipment there anyway, and that was when they made all their snow to cover the slalom, GS, Super G, and downhill courses. I think at Mount Van Hovenberg, they could only cover like half the trails they wanted to. So in order to do a really long race, they had to, you know, the racers had to go around the same track twice, so to speak. It did snow during the Olympics a little bit, but of course that's just, you know, after the fact, that really didn't help anything because it wasn't enough to improve or, add any more trails out there, especially at Mount Van Hovenberg.